Hey everyone, Jason Shepard here of MzeroA.com. Welcome into part three of our aviation weather series, The Power of PIREPs. And we're going to be talking and reading PIREPs here a little bit today and learning more. First off, what is a PIREP? A PIREP is a pilot report. Who uses these PIREPs? Well, of course, other pilots are going to use PIREPs. The flight service station is also going to use those to help get data out to other pilots. And air traffic control is going to use PIREPs as well. I love finding PIREPs. Yes, METARs are great, TAFs are awesome, but sometimes hearing it from someone who I may be in their shoes in a couple miles, or I was in times past, it's nice to hear what's really happening up there. Because show of hands, who's been flying before the conditions say this, and they end up really being totally different. There was never that icing forecast like we talked about last week, and we end up finding ourselves in icing conditions. A PIREP could have saved all of that time and helped us make a no-go decisions. Now, did you know that ATC is actually required to solicit PIREPs when? Well, first off, when requested by another pilot, if another pilot's asking where are the tops, where are the bottoms, any questions like that, ATC is asked to solicit other pilots. When the ceiling is at or less than 5,000 feet, when visibility is at or less than 5 miles, there's thunderstorms present in the area, moderate or greater turbulence is present, light or greater icing is present, wind shear or volcanic ash is present as well. ATC is required to solicit PIREPs, because we as pilots are not always that generous with our information when we give it out. Why is that? Maybe we're a little bit intimidated to do so. You know, there was a time a ways back to give a PIREP, you had to call a flight service station or call flight watch or remember to do it when you're on the ground. Nowadays, it's as simple as just telling the controller, hey, 2-3 Mike Zulu, climbing through 4,000 feet, picked up some light rime ice, request ascent to 3,000 feet, because I want to get out of it, but I'm also reporting to them, hey, in this area, at 4,000 feet, my climb, I started picking up light rime ice. I just gave a PIREP. Now, you say, well, that's not the most complete PIREP, Jason. You didn't tell them your type, you didn't tell them your location. Well, ATC knows all that already. If I'm on my proper IFR flight plan or VFR flight following, whatever that may be, they can then go, workload permitting, and fill in those blanks and get that PIREP out there for me. That being said, there's some other ways to submit PIREPs, but let's look at one that did it a little bit differently. Starting out, first TXK, that's kind of our reporting agency that got that out there. This is a UA. There's two types of PIREPs. UA is a routine PIREP. UUA is an urgent PIREP. This is a routine UA PIREP over, then they give you the airport. K4, Oscar 4, I believe is what that is. TM is our time, 2332 Zulu. FL, flight levels. In this case, we're just at 1,900 feet. TP is type. It is a BE-36, a Beechcraft Bonanza, I believe, is a BE-36. If you ever, for some reason, don't know the type, you can literally Google BE-36, or our next one's a CRJ-9. You could Google that and find out what these PIREPs actually are. So this is from a Beechcraft Bonanza. I like when general aviation aircraft give a PIREP because it's more relatable to me than when a CRJ-9 gives a PIREP way up at altitude, maybe. So it's a Beechcraft Bonanza. SK, skies. For the skies, the bases are at 1900. Remarks. Then it gets into ZFW, AWC, web. What on earth does all that mean? Well, what it essentially means here is they used aviationweather.gov to submit this PIREP. And if you have an aviationweather.gov account, you can go ahead and there's something called a PIREP entry form access request. And once you're logged in, you register for an account, it's kind of cumbersome. You actually have to reach out and contact them and say, hey, I have an account. I'd like you to unlock my ability to send you all PIREPs. And then once they unlock that, you can go through and send your PIREPs through AWC, the Aviation Weather Center. Look in this PIREP in the remarks, AWC, Aviation Weather Center web. That's exactly how this pilot did that. Now, of course, that requires you to land, hop on the phone or get back to the house, type all this out and put that in there. That's a diligent pilot, though, who took those extra steps to make sure a PIREP got out there. I hope one day there's a much easier way to do things, but this is one of many ways to actually get PIREPs out there. So if you Google PIREP entry form access for AWC, that will come up so you can get that submitted. Let's read another PIREP here together. LIT, again, the area, the agency working on this, I believe that's Little Rock. UA is a routine PIREP. OV, again, I believe LIT is Little Rock. Time, 2215 Zulu. Flight level 009900 feet. Type, a CRJ-9. Must be on a climb out or descent then, I hope. Skies, broken at 900. T-O-P-U-N-K-N. Tops, unknown. And then remarks, the D-U-R-D, just like we said, during descent. It was D-U-R-C, during climb. But this is during our descent. So they broke out of the broken layer at 900 feet. Probably shooting their approach, it sounds like, into Little Rock. PIREPs are first-hand knowledge of what's happening up there. They don't have to be conditions like this with icing or turbulence or whatever it is that you can say, you know what, it is a gorgeous day today and I'm going to give a PIREP. That is perfectly fine as well. It helps me justify my decision. It says it's going to be great on the METARs. It says it'll be great on the TAFs. You know what? I found a PIREP that also confirms that. It allows me to check a few more boxes knowing that it's probably going to be a great day to fly. PIREPs, whether it's good weather or bad weather, are an asset to us out there. And PIREPs are something we're going to dig deeper into on Thursday, April 30th. I am doing a live weather analysis. Thursday, April 30th, 3 p.m. on the MzeroA.com YouTube and Facebook, probably right here where you're watching this video now. There is a link to RSVP in the description if you wish to check this out and RSVP so you get some reminders and we can let you know that we're going live. I'll be taking a challenging flight plan. We'll look that day and see where there's some actual weather to fly through. And we'll go ahead and we'll flight plan that through on a VFR flight as well as an IFR flight. You'll be able to ask questions live and see us kind of pivot and make go and no-go decisions in real time. Just like if we were really going to make that flight. So it's a live weather analysis. It's Thursday, April 30th at 3 p.m. I hope you will check that out. And lastly, I hope you're going to join us on the Aviation Mastery at Sea, October 26th through the 31st out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. My good friend Steve Owen Canivo will be joining us there as well. So many great breakout sessions for VFR, IFR, the co-pilot course I've been talking so much about, and of course a drone track as well. So we'll hopefully be doing some great drone flying in the islands as well. Everything from drones to technical IFR for flight procedures, we're going to be covering and learning more about all aspects of aviation. Aviationmastery.com to check that out and learn more. And I look forward to seeing you all on the cruise. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and most importantly, remember, a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya. I wrote the private pilot blueprint with the intention of, if I could do my flight training over, would I wish someone would have told me? And I want that book to be yours for free. All I ask is that you pay shipping. Visit privatepilotblueprint.com to get your free copy.